Yeah, we're looking at it again. I guess this is part two. I don't know how much longer this will last. But it's amazing how my old brain works and how it sometimes it doesn't work. Big shout out to everybody that jumped in and said that they had these bushings, which are just grommets. They're nothing special. But I haven't thought about this for a long, long time. It's just sort of hung on the wall, and I wanted to get to it, and I knew what I had to do. Now I'm in it. All right. And I'm laying in bed last night, and I'm thinking, I'm sure I have another whole set of these that I bought a long time ago, probably at a swap meet, or I don't even know where I got them. But they're not bent and they're in good shape, and they actually have bushings which are a little better than the grommets. I'm going to have to alter the headstock slightly to take the bushings, but there you go. And then just, from the other video, everybody was yagging off in the comments. These still worked, they're just bent. All right, they still tuned the bass. I found in my stuff a really nice set of Fender brand flat wound strings, which actually fit through there. So I'm happy with this for now. I'm not going to do any much more because I really do want to do a little bit of work on the frets. And but let's look at the electronics and start with that. I don't know how far I'm going to get, but we can start by pulling it out, which I have done before. More background noise going on in here right now. Humidifiers and furnaces, and when it gets this cold, the furnace barely stops, right? It'll cycle and then it'll stop for maybe 10 minutes, and then that's it. This is gonna pop out of there for me. So the other plan here is to eventually get the three-ply black pick guard made, so it looks like the picture that I love of Ronnie from the Small Faces playing one of these. I have to find the picture. It's a cool picture. And I do know this thing. Like, I'd never take this out and play it on stage, but I do know it records like a demon. Oh, let's just see if it makes noise, because I think it did last time I plugged it in. Sounds about right. That sound. But there's no tone control because this is poached, so it's just straight out. Okay. That's all I needed to know.
I ain't quite sure about that, but it kind of looks like this might have been fixed before, or someone tried to. I can't remember. It's been so long since I had it apart. But if we look inside, I'll get the light better. Maybe it'll show up. There it is. Full 62. Made in the USA.
Well, there's your problem. And someone's been in this before. And the diagram I have doesn't have the capacitors over at the switch. But this is all original. This is not. Someone's put that in, and it was hell getting it out and hell getting it in. And yeah, we're not doing that again. This one, I did a little test fit. It'll be tight, but I can do it. Let's peel the capacitors off there and see what they are. 0.005 microfarads. 65 nanofarads. Do the math. I think we're in range. 4.08 nanofarads equals. Huh? Check that other one again. Well, if I look close, that's good. But this one, point 0.1 microfarad, But that ain't what I get on my meter. Okay. Yeah, folks, that capacitor ain't capacitating the way it's supposed to. I'll have to look through my stuff. I don't think I have one like that. Aha! Look what Davey found in his stuff. I'm so happy. It's the only one. Don't wreck it. 102 nanofarads equals decimal point, decimal point, decimal point. 0.1 microfarads. Woohoo! Many times it's best just to walk away and then come back. So when I examine the mock-up of a rewire of this, they show this capacitor being on the tone control. Also don't show this lug of the pot being grounded to the body. But they've done this, so I think in the original wiring, they ran this back and they put the capacitor on the switch and grounded it out that way. I'm not sure about this jumper, and what I've decided to do is, because I really never want to go back inside this ever again, I am going to use new parts and do this, and then possibly use this as a bit of reference to understand what they did with the tone. Most of the time you see a tone pot with one lug bent over and grounded to the body. So they've done that jump. I think they put the capacitor at this end and then attach it to ground on the switch. I'm going to do this. So let's make a template and get some parts out and start putting it together. Some clear stuff. Always remember to mark your sexual orientation. This will be top. And looking for something picky and pointy, this will work. Alright, so it's going to be there, boink, boink, right, don't screw it up. Come on, you can do it. There we go. And let's make some holes in that, and let's put the parts in it. So here's a tip. Don't swim in Lake Ontario. No. Here's a tip. Okay, I'm right here. So you see how there's two wires that are going to connect to that one post? Well, a common mistake is people put one wire and then they add a wire and then they add a wire and they add a wire. So as for instance for here, there's two wires that are going to connect to that one dot of solder. I'm going to hit that once. Same thing with this. I'm going to get both wires where they need to go and hit it once with the soldering iron, right? Keeps it neat, right? That's where you see the big blobs that keep adding and adding and adding, and what a mess. Well, that's pretty much the circuit, folks, except for one more ground connection, and the ground from the pickup goes there and the hot. So I'm going to pause, clean everything up, get the guitar body back over here, jumper the pickup into this circuit, make sure it all works. Then I'll make the final solder connections. Then we're going to pull it into the base. There's still lots to do. I still got to do the frets, which isn't a big deal. And so happy I found the tuners. I had a dream I owned them, and the dream came true, because I did. All the links to amazing things are below, and a big shout out to this guy for drawing this out. Like I said, it's not exactly what I see here, but I understand what probably really happened, and they put the other capacitor on the switch. See much of a difference as far as sonic world goes. It's going to be cool. All the links to great things are below in the description. Get a sticker, get a Petty Black CD. If you sent me money and you didn't get your stuff, please like make sure I got your address, because PayPal keeps changing their freaking interface. And every time somebody wants to send me money, they request money. What the frick is going on with the world? Tweakers. It works great. Let's change it. All right, folks. Join the Facebook group. Subscribe. Become a patron. Special shout out to all my patrons. And what else? Twitter me. And be good to each other and be safe. Cheers.